So I'm going to jump into this. This is the book of Revelations 8 and 13, right? So, it's 8 and 13. So I read, it says, Revelation 8 and 13, it says, "And I beheld and heard an angel flying through the midst of heaven, saying with a loud voice, woe, woe, woe." Right, and the word woe basically means destruction or world war. Right, so he said the word woe 3 times. Right, so he said, "The inhabitants of the earth to the inhabitants of the earth by reason of the other voices of the trumpet of the 3 angels which are yet to sound," right? And what that's talking about, it's talking about 3 world wars, right? Because 3 world wars were prophesied in the Bible to happen, and 2 have already happened. So I'm going to read that to show you, right? So this is Revelations 11 and 14, all right? It says, "The second woe is past." So the second world war is past. You had the first world war from 1914, I believe, to 1918. And you had the second world war from 1939 to 1945, right? And the first world war was basically the war to end all wars. They called it the Great War, right? And they also named it the War to End All Wars, because that was the first world war where you basically had what's this thing called? Post-industrial revolution, right? So you had a different form of technology being utilized in that warfare. So people had guns, bombs and whatnot, whereas they used swords and, you know, stars and all that kind of thing. So it presented a different challenge to the earth. That's why they said it was a war to end all wars, right? So when you look it up and you see the history and how people were affected by it, you had a thing known as shell shock, right? People were shell shocked, and the reason why they were shell shocked is because of the bombing, right? The sounds of bombs, the sounds of gunfire. It basically caused PTSD and a lot of the soldiers that were in that warfare, okay, by way of how terrible it was, all right? So that was the First World War. Then you had a second in 1939 to 1945. And then when you look at it on the left-hand side, the Lord in the Bible basically prophesied all these things happening. But also, you have the elites of the society, starting the banking families. They basically have an agenda they're playing out in this day and age, all right? And all those world wars were utilized to establish themselves upon the earth, all right? Establish their rulership on the earth. So this is Revelations 11 and 14. It says the second war was passed, right? The second war passed in 1945, 1939 to 1945. That's the second world war, right? And it says, "And behold, the third war cometh quickly," right? So it said the third war cometh quickly. And it's the thing, because people don't understand the ideal of time to you, all right, is not the same as it is to the Heavenly Father. Right, because even this nigga died on what's his name, King Von. Right, and I'm glad that nigga's dead, man. If I'll be honest, basically, his run. You look at these people in the criminal world and all that type of stuff, drug dealers and whatnot. They might have a crazy run where they make it's lucrative, and then their name rings bells and whatnot. But then guess what? It comes to an abrupt end, and when you look back at it, it only lasted 2 years, right? It didn't actually last as long as you thought. At the time when they were sitting on top of the world, you thought they could never fall off. Or even let's walk away from a crime enterprise. We deal with athletes. You have athletes like football players, basketball players, ice hockey players, what have you. They may be the guy for 2 seasons, but then after those 2 seasons, guess what? Their name falls out of favor. Because they ain't doing the same acts. They ain't doing the same things that they were once doing, all right? So they ain't held in high esteem no more, all right? But I want to get a scrap scripture. willing, I do, man. Bear with me one moment. So this is 2 Peter's 3:3, right? So it reads, it says, knowing this first, that there shall come in the last days scoffers walking after their own lust, right? And that's why you have a lot of people coming on the comment boards. You have, you know, brothers' videos get uploaded and they instantly get a dislike. Why is that now? Why is that happening? It's a fulfillment of prophecy, right? When you read the book of Revelation, the 19th chapter, it tells you the testimony of Yahweh Shai is the spirit of prophecy, okay? So even when you, what you have in court, someone makes a testimony, or they testify, all right? So that they provide their testimony, basically. They present it, all right? So the presentation of Yahweh Shai's spirit is done by prophecy, right? The fulfillment of it. And this is fulfilled right here. So it's 2 Peter 3:3. Knowing this first, that there shall come in the last days scoffers walking after their own lust. And that also signifies the fact that we're in the last days as well. Alright? So it says, and saying, where is the promise of his coming? For since the fathers fell asleep, all things continue as were from the beginning of creation. Alright? And that's where you have people.
That's in what spirit people come scoffing. Alright? They say, look, man. Since the fathers fell asleep, the forefathers written in the book, in the Bible, since they've gone to sleep,
basically everything's going on as normal.
Right? What's Peter gonna say? It says, for
this they willingly are ignorant.
Right? Ignorant of that by the word of the Most High, the heavens were of old, and the earth standing out of water, and in the water. Right? Whereby the world that then was being overflowed with water perished, right? So as in the time of Noah, okay? So it says, but the heavens and the earth, which are now, by the same word, are kept in store, reserved for fire again, unto fire against the day of judgment and perdition of ungodly men, right? So basically, they lack faith and understanding that. In the days of old, the Heavenly Father basically made this world, right? It tells you in the book of Hebrews, they basically made the world by way of the word, right? The invisible made the visible world, basically, right? The spirits and the angels, which the spirits are the angels. But then also, what they don't get is that those same spirits are keeping everything in
order at this point in time as well now.
And they're keeping them in order until the time of, like as it happened in Noah, they're keeping them in order for the time of destruction, right? And that's going to happen on the cut, basically, when World War III happens. Ultimately, this fire that's being spoken of in this book is basically going to come into play, right? So it says, but beloved, be not ignorant of this one thing. Now, this is the point, this is the reason why I'm reading it. It says that one day is with
the Lord a thousand
years, and 1,000 years as one day. So time, the way time is measured to the Heavenly Father, one day to him is 1,000 years, right? So down here, if you spend 40 years, I believe it's around 40 years is an hour to the Heavenly Father, alright? So if you have a time period of 40 years is an hour, right? So you think about that, that shows you that the scale of time to him is not what you think it is, alright? So now let me go back to Matthew 24. Because all these things are happening now, alright? It's a countdown. That's why I said it, 2020 is a year for the records, and 2021 is going to be even crazier, right? So it says, Matthew 24:6, and ye shall hear of wars and rumors of wars, see that ye be not troubled, right? And who's not going to be troubled? Ultimately, the people that are not going to be troubled are the ones that are in the faith, right? Because we have understanding. It tells you in the book of Isaiah 33:6, wisdom and knowledge shall be the stability of thy times and the strength of your salvation. Right? So where's the wisdom and knowledge? Because there's wisdom and knowledge in everything. But there's one that supersedes all wisdom and knowledge, alright? And that's the words of this book, the prophecy of this book. Right? It says verse 7, for nation shall rise against nation and kingdom against kingdom, and there shall be famines and pestilences and earthquakes in diverse places. Right, so I've got to read that again. So it says, for nation shall rise against nation. And that's what you're having right now. You got skirmishes down in Armenia, and I'm trying to remember, I can't pronounce his name, his country, Ahmadinejad or something like that. They're having a skirmish right now, right? You're having multiple countries having skirmishes right now, and yeah, you've got infighting within nations as well. Right? Like, for example, you got down, right now, you got more or less the Democrats versus Republicans down there in America, right? And that's down to, that's the fulfillment of prophecy in the Bible as well. So if Satan be divided against Satan, how then shall his kingdom stand? Right? And when the Bible speaks of Satan, it's talking about Esau, Edom, right? As today, they're not. Esau, Edom, starting with the elites of this world, have basically repackaged themselves as so-called white people, okay? But your true nationality is Edomites, right? Everyone has a biblical nationality. When you go to the book of Genesis, the 10th chapter, it breaks down the table of nations, all right? It gives you every nation according to their genealogy, right? Starting with, you know, the three sons of Noah, Shem, Ham, and Japheth, alright? So anyway, it reads, it says, verse 7, it says, for nation shall rise against nation, right? And that's what we're seeing right now. And kingdom against kingdom, and there shall be famines and pestilences, alright? The word famine basically means a lack of bread, alright? So it doesn't actually mean, you could have a famine where it's a severe famine, basically, to the point where people don't have no food whatsoever, right? But famine basically means a lack thereof, right? So if you have a lack of bread, you can basically, you can put that on what's going on right now, right? Going back to the time of March, April, in the UK, if any, you know, what happened when you went into the stores? You couldn't get no toilet roll, mind you, but you couldn't get certain grains. With certain beans and whatnot, and you had people buying perishable items as well. That basically was a form of famine, right? And that's what's going on. And guess what? That famine's gonna get worse, right? Because it's prophesied in the Bible. So it says, and there shall be famines and pestilences and earthquakes in diverse places, right? And the word pestilences basically means diseases, right? And that's what you got going on right now. You got this coronavirus, right, which basically is a pestilence, right? They're definitely chalking up the numbers a bit higher than where it really is and making it sound more severe than where it really is. But guess what? The real thing is it actually is a virus, okay? It is a form of disease. It is a form of pestilence, okay? But they're utilizing it as a guise to establish their new world order. And that's the reason why they're presenting it so heavy in the media. Okay? So it says, and it also said an earthquake in diverse places, right? And that's why you've had earthquakes on a consistent basis throughout the past couple months, man. Right? So reading on, it says, and these are the beginning of sorrows, right? So all these things that you're seeing are the beginnings of sorrow, because we're going to head into the time known as Jacob's trouble, right? The hour of temptation, as spoke of in the book of Jeremiah, the 30th chapter, and also spoken of in Revelation, the third chapter, right? That's the time we're heading into. Actually, I might as well get that, right?